Well, hello there, all you amazing people. There's not much going on here. This is just me airing my thoughts out. Call them Kent's Thoughts. There's a playlist for it that will be up in some form of whatnot up there. And I need to move my camera a little bit because I feel like I'm all the way down in the bottom. There you go. I moved up in the world. Oh, I moved up a little bit. If you hear some noises, we got new neighbors. So they will be doing, you know, stuff like that I'm recording on a Sunday. But Windows End of Life, or Windows 10 End of Life, October 14th, 2025. There's already YouTube channels out there, both on the Linux side and the Windows side, being like, what are we doing now? What is going to go on? What are those people using Windows 10, Windows 11 going to be doing? What's Windows 10 and 11? Windows 10, what are they going to do? Are they jumping to Linux? Are they jumping to Mac? What are they going to be doing? I'm going to say something here that most people are not going to like. This has been a talk ever since Linux came into the market. Or well, ever since Windows was a thing. Is that every year or every time a Windows release is going to be end of life. The Linux community have always said this. And just go watch videos. When Windows 7 came end of life, there was a spurt of Linux videos about, hey, now Windows users are moving over to Linux because hardware demands for Windows 8 and blah, blah, blah. When Windows 8 ended, got to end of life, oh, Windows users are moving over to Linux because higher requirements of hardware for Windows and so on and so on. Now they're doing it with Windows 10. And now their argument is TPM, the good old TPM, Trusted Platform Module. Will that now be the final coffin in Windows users to moving to Linux? As we all know that have seen this talk, we all know that's not the case. And you may say, why? They need to buy new hardware. No, here's how the landscape is. And this is like 9 out of 10 times or 99% of what is going to happen. Windows 10 reaches end of life. Cannot use it anymore. Well, you can use it, but it's not getting massively updates. It's not getting new features. Unless there's like a massive security risk, they're not going to fix it. They will, if there is a massive security risk, fix it. They've done it before. So here's what people are going to do. They're going to stick with Windows 10 because most software still support Windows 10. Steam, browsers, games, DirectX, blah, 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 still supports Windows 10. So most users are just being like, eh, don't give a fuck. They already have an antivirus and blah, 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 malware. So 99% of their, or not 99%, but let's say 80% of their attack vectors is already covered. If you have an up-to-date antivirus, if you have an up-to-date malware and stuff like that, which is the most used attack vectors by malicious people. That's what they're doing the most. They are using viruses and botnets and malware. So if you have an up-to-date antivirus and malware, as most users on Windows have, you don't have an issue. Well, you don't have an issue towards that. You know, there could still be backdoors in Windows and stuff like that. We have to look at what is the world in security right now. The good old days where your computer was the de facto place for all of your data meant that your computer was really important. Nowadays, it's everything is up there. It's up in the cloud, it's up in the sky. Basically, every data about you, I just activated Google Assistant here. Every data there's about you is both on your local machine, on your phone, but also in the cloud. So unless you are like, let's say, Tim Cook, or what is the CEO for Microsoft, or Elon Musk, or someone like that, or you're working for the government doing research and development for the army and stuff like that. Unless you're one of those like under 1% of society, your computer is kind of meaningless. Why am I saying that? Well, look at it like this. If you are an attacker, you want to get data from people. You can spend, let's say, 2 hours attacking your home computer, or you can spend 2 hours attacking a server or something in the cloud that if you get in, you're not only getting access to one person's data, thousands of people. That's why that personal attacks is gone away mostly to corporate computers, the cloud, you know, so other people's computers where you store your data. And that's why it's really, really important that you have correct data protection in the services that you're using, that you have really good password hygiene and email hygiene. I should probably make a video about that. That don't mean that you should be like, fuck my computer, I'm not having firewalls and all that. I'm just, no, they are never going to hack my computer. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying is that it's not as important to be batshit sinful head crazy about your local computer as it was 10, 15, 20 years ago. What they are targeting your computer for is making it part of a botnet. Antivirus programs and malware can help you with that. What they are targeting your computer for is password, you know, keystroke recording, password recording, handshaking, encrypted handshaking between you and the services that you're logging in for. Your password, or not your password, if you have a password protector, but your email, malware, and stuff like that should take care of that. Also, your browser, if you're using this little thing called HTTPS, is way more secure than a VPN is when it comes to protecting your data, by the way. Why you should not buy a VPN other than seeing Netflix in other countries, but that's another rant I can go into. You will probably be vulnerable if you're not getting security updates for Windows 10, but you're kind of a little bit protected in the same nature that Linux is protected with obscurity, or with, people don't care that much about your physical computer anymore. Again, unless you're doing stuff that people really, 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 really want to get their hands on. So you should take your notepad out and you should write down, what data do people want from me? If I was to hack myself, or if I was a hacker or a malicious person, which goal is to get money, how much would I get from my own data? Or how much would I get from my family's members' data? Here's what's happening 9 out of 10 times when, you know, I love your malware, and malware in general is being done on physical computers at home. Here's what they're doing 9 out of 10 times. They're just paving over that socket. They are uninstalling everything, even sometimes throwing out the hardware, or not the hardware, the hard disk, and putting in a new hard disk, because hard drives nowadays cost nothing. Why are people doing that? Well, that's because most people have all their family photos and all of those kind of things backed up in the cloud. So with that in mind, who gives a fuck if Windows 10 is getting end of life or end of support? Most people not giving a fuck. I'm still helping people running Windows 7. I still at work got computers from massive companies that went under, that were running XP computers, because that computer controlled a machine where the software and the machine just fucking worked. And there were no reason to upgrade from that XP computer to another computer or another Windows system, because who knows what fucking issues you're going to go into right now. And a lot of people have that mentality, especially home users, and especially when they know that... I forgot I had my phone plugged in, by the way, to my charger. That's how stupid I am. Like, most people, they look at this here, this is a phone. Do we physically copy all of our fucking data from one phone to another? No, it's... All of it is up in the cloud. Again, I'm not saying you should not care about security at home, but you need to do it in an appropriate way. I sadly see too many people be like, oh my god, I'm encrypting every fucking thing they can encrypt and secure on their local physical computer, and then their password is 123456789010. Or they're using the same email all over the fucking place with the same password for everything in the cloud. Or they're using a third party password manager that has been hacked the last fucking 10 times the last 5 months or something like that, because for some reason they don't want to write down stuff down on a piece of paper, but they trust someone's other computer in the cloud where they're storing all the sensitive data on that could be, like, if I hack like OnePass or one of those password managers cloud structure databases, just imagine how much shit I can do and damage I can do to thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people in some of those databases cases. An operating system's end of life or end of support don't matter so much as it did in the 90s and early 2000s, where we didn't store everything in the cloud and everything we had was local. Everything we did was local. And the more we moved over to this, when the cloud became like a buzzword, less and less we're doing locally. What Windows 10 end of support could mean, like I said, it's stuff like backdoors, bug fixes, feature fixes, and stuff like that you're losing out on. Everything else is handled by other programs. We are talking about home users, people that would be the potential Mac Windows users in the future, Mac Linux users in the future. Nothing is going to happen in 2025 with Linux. It has never happened with Linux, and TPM is not going to get people over to Linux, because people will still be running Windows 10 until their software don't support it anymore, which will take probably close to a decade before that happens, or at least five, six, 7 years. Look how long or how much software you can still install on Windows 7, by the way. So that's not going to be an issue. TPM, well, people run the operating system their computer comes with, and then they buy a new computer. So when people are going to be needing TPM, that's probably when their hardware is getting too slow for what they're doing. But then they're going to buy a new computer, laptop, whatever it is, maybe even not, maybe go over to a tablet, but they're going to buy new hardware that then already have TPM in it. You will see a really, really, really minute small influx in Linux users, almost non-recognizable, barely registered on the graph of Linux desktop users. It's been like that forever. Every time a Windows release is like end of support, people are coming out. Oh my God, they're going over to Mac. Oh my God, they're going over to Linux. Windows is doomed. They've said that all the time. And you may have a little bit stronger argument with the TPM if you don't understand how the psychology of computer users are within the Windows ecosystem. Windows users don't upgrade Windows releases as people upgrade Apple products and Linux products. Most people only upgrade Windows when they need new hardware, or if there is an automatically update available for them. Like if you're running Windows 10 and your computer can run Windows 11, you get like a pop-up, do you want to install Windows 11? Some say yes, some say no. That's when they are going to do it. They may call up their local nerd. Hey, Joe, should I upgrade to Windows 11? Oh, fuck no. Okay, no. That's to the extent that Windows users upgrade distro or operating system. They don't, every time a new version of Windows comes out, they don't flock to the stores or flock to the online download places and download the ISO and upgrade as Mac users and Linux users do. They have never done that. Windows users upgrade operating system when their hardware is getting outdated. It's been like that for over 30 years. So this propaganda, if you can call it, and it comes both from the Mac user camp and the Linux users camp, about every time there's an end of support, end of life, or whatever you call it with a Windows release, they're like, yes, now we're going to snatch up some users. And you probably are, but not to the extent that you think you are. Windows will stay about what it is today. Linux will stay about what it is today. Mac OS is going to stay about what it is today. That's the nature of things. And how can I say this with that certainty? Again, look at the data over the last 30 years. A lot of smart people are saying this. If you want to predict future behavior, look at past behavior. What have users done in the past when this situation came up? They just didn't upgrade. The last example we had of this was Windows Vista, where people needed new hardware to run Windows Vista because of RAM requirement and computer CPU requirement and stuff like that. You know what people did? They didn't upgrade to Windows Vista, or they waited until they needed a new hardware and then they upgraded to Windows Vista. It was not that big of a deal. That was what they did in the past. What did they do in the Windows ME 95, 98 when Windows XP came out? Because that was also a system that required quite a bit of oomph from your computer. But if they had a computer that couldn't run Windows XP, they didn't upgrade. And then when they bought a new computer, they got Windows XP with it. That's how Windows users upgrade operating system. That's how Windows users look at operating system. Most Windows 8 users today or Windows 7 users today that are still using those two systems have no clue that they are end of life, end of support. They have no clue. They may have seen an article or pop up on their system say, you do know that you're getting end of life. Yeah, fuck. Pestering me, your stupid system, and clicking no, and then that's it. And they forget everything about it. They go fuck the wife or the husband. They go get some fucking pepperoni pizzas and they already forget everything about it. Go for a smoke. It's already out of their mind. We are putting too much of our own worldview as tech people, tech enthusiasts, hobbyists within the tech world onto people that are not like us. We expect or think that everyone think like us because we do. That's a really, again, I've said this a lot of video, that's a really like arrogant and narcissistic way of thinking of the world. Like it would be like a mechanic saying that everyone driving a car know how to fix their car because we do, or thinking about cars in the same way that we do because we are mechanics. No. We have to recognize that just the fact that we are thinking about this makes us 1% of computer users. The fact that we are concerned about this makes us 1% of computer users. So the way we look at it and we think about it is how 1% of computer users probably will, maybe 2%. So basically most computer users are not going to give a fuck about this at all. They're just living their life. When their software starts not working on Windows 10 or their hardware gets too slow to run the software they want to run, they just go buy a new computer. They're like either that or upgrading the new one. They're like, oh, it would get too expensive to upgrade it compared to buying a new computer. It's like, funny enough, if you just want an entry-level computer doing office work, it's sometimes cheaper to actually buy the computer pre-built than building it nowadays. Most of the time, it's only gamers that need to build their own computer because they can reuse old hardware, unless they're changing from old to new technologies as we are doing right now, but that's another video. This end of life, end of support, Windows X version is going to not be supported anymore means basically nothing for anyone other than us. And we are like 1% of the totem pole. How many of you are running an Android version that is too old and not being updated anymore? Most Android manufacturers only update Android security wise and for like 2 or 4 years. This one has the first of Samsung that's doing it, I think, in 4 years, where they are bug fixing and security update. Most of the time, most Android vendors, they stop supporting Android on a phone when it's 2 years old. So how many of you are running an Android phone that's over 2 years old? That's like running Windows 10 on your Android. It's not getting security fixes, it's not getting bug fixes from the manufacturer anymore. So if you can run an Android phone that's 3-4 years old and have no issues, you can run fucking Windows 10 with no issues. It's the same shit. You probably have more sensitive data here. You have like social security numbers connected to this one. You have passports, driver license, health thingamajiggy, your bank, like online banking and shit like that is connected to this one here. You probably have 2, 3, 4 payment methods connected to this one. Heck, you even probably use it to buy shit with while running an Android system that is not getting properly updated. And you are concerned about Windows 10. Yeah, it don't make sense when you think about it that way. So it's not a big deal for most people. Most people are not going to give a fuck about it. Their life is not going to be impacted whatsoever. And the whole TPM, it's not going to be an issue for most people because they are just buying a new hardware when they need new hardware that will automatically have TPM on it. So they don't even know that they are running TPM. Most people running Windows 10 with secure boot and all that fucking extra security features don't even know they are running secure boot and stuff like that until a nerd comes and tells them, oh, you're running secure boot. See you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.